The vice president checks out new Earth science work, 2 decades and counting of continuous human presence in space, and 29 days on the edge for the Webb Space Telescope team. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. Vice President Kamala Harris visited our Goddard Space Flight Center on November 5th for a firsthand look at how NASA's wide array of Earth science missions provide crucial information to help address the climate challenges facing our planet.
This image just came in.
The Vice President was also on hand with NASA Administrator Bill Nelson and other officials as we unveiled the first images from Landsat 9, a joint mission of NASA and the U.S. Geological Survey that launched in late September. The images, all captured on October 31st, provide a preview of how the mission will help people manage vital natural resources and track the impacts of climate change, adding to Landsat's data record of space-based Earth observation that spans nearly 50 years.
Climate change is an existential threat, and we must take immediate action to address it. As our nation works to meet our climate commitments, we know that our actions cannot be limited to only what we can do on Earth. With the perspective we have gained from space, we have been reminded of how precious our Earth really is.
NASA data has the power to change and even save lives. If we do not use the data that is available to us to make some real changes, the impacts of climate change will only get worse. To borrow a phrase from the legendary flight director, Gene Kranz, when it comes to climate change, failure is not an option.
Learn more about NASA's Earth science work at nasa.gov/earth. October 31st marked the start of the 21st straight year of humans living and working in space. Expedition 1, the first resident crew to live and work on board the International Space Station, launched on Halloween in 2000. The science and technology research conducted on board the space station is critical to helping us understand and overcome the challenges of long-duration spaceflight and necessary for a long-term presence on the Moon and missions deeper into the solar system, including to Mars. NASA is working with the U.S. Navy off the coast of San Diego, California, on the final certification run to verify and validate procedures and hardware to recover the Orion spacecraft after it splashes down in the Pacific Ocean at the end of our uncrewed Artemis 1 mission. Orion is targeted to launch atop our Space Launch System rocket on Artemis 1, its first deep space mission to pave the way for future flights with astronauts. This year's launch of our James Webb Space Telescope will be followed by a rather tense 29 days on edge for the Webb team. During that time, thousands of parts must work correctly and in sequence to unfold the telescope and put it into its final configuration. With more than 300 single-point failure items, this will be the most complex sequence of deployments ever attempted in a single space mission. Webb is targeted for launch December 18th on its mission to reveal new and unexpected discoveries and help humanity understand the origins of the universe and our place in it. NASA's Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART mission, is currently targeted for launch no earlier than November 24th from Vandenberg Space Force Base in California. The mission could help determine if intentionally crashing a spacecraft into an asteroid is an effective way to change its course, should we discover an asteroid on a collision course with Earth in the future. In fall 2022, DART will impact the asteroid moonlet Dimorphos, which orbits a larger asteroid named Didymos. Neither of these is a threat to Earth. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.